Welcome to another edition of Florida Newsmakers. I'm Tramell Gomes with our very special guest, Nick Wiley, the Executive Director of the Florida Fish and Wildlife Conservation Commission. Welcome to the program.
Thank you, Tramell. Glad to be here.
Let's get right to it. 18 years after Florida voters approved the ban on gill nets, the issue is back in court. Why do you think the net ban should stay in place?
Well, first, as you noted, it was a constitutional amendment approved by the people of Florida. And there is clear evidence that the restrictions on gill nets has had a big benefit to our inshore fisheries and that ecosystem. So we feel like there's a valid reason for it, but we're not really focused so much on whether it should stay in place or not. We're really going to work with the judicial system, work through that process, and do our best to honor that system and get to an outcome and then go from there.
What do you say to opponents who are arguing that the rules crafted to ease overfishing is actually contributing to the problem?
Yeah, the argument that we hear a lot is that the nets that are allowed for use are sane nets, but they're used in a manner that they do catch small fish. The truth in that matter is, yes, some small fish are caught, but it's a negligible amount, and it's not having an impact on the fisheries resources. We've got clear scientific data and monitoring that indicates that that's not an impact. Whereas the larger gill nets actually clearly did have an impact, and we've clearly seen a benefit from those being limited.
Now, there's some unfortunate news that recently happened where a black bear attacked a woman in Longwood. What's the current status of that situation?
We're taking that one very seriously. The lady was injured seriously, and our hearts go out to her family. She and her family now, and we're doing all we can there. We're very active in that neighborhood with patrols and trapping. We've caught a small bear. It wasn't the bear that was involved, we're pretty sure. So we're going to be very focused on trying to capture the bear that was a part of this problem and take care of that bear and continue to work with that neighborhood, because it is in an area where there are a lot of bears in the wild nearby. So that's an ongoing concern that we are very focused on and taking very seriously.
Let's switch to the wildlife and habitat in the Everglades. That's a big priority for your agency, but you said protecting that habitat can be done by just managing the water levels. Explain.
Well, absolutely, because over the thousands of years, the wildlife, fish and wildlife in the Everglades adapted to ebbs and flows in water levels over the season each year. And as the water comes up to a certain level, they adapt to that. As it comes down, they adapt. And their ability to find food and to reproduce and nest and things like that is critical to small changes in water elevations. And right now the system is out of balance, and we have high water periods when wildlife needs it to be lower. We have low water periods when wildlife needs it to be higher. So we're working very closely with all of our partners that are involved in Everglades restoration to try to help make sure restoration recognizes those needs and concerns of fish and wildlife. At the same time, we're recognizing the needs of the people in South Florida.
An ongoing battle for your agency is finding ways to eradicate invasive species like the lionfish and pythons. You had the python challenge this year that gained international attention. Will we see the return of the python challenge next year?
We're looking right now to learn from that experience. We learned a lot, and it did get great attention. We're trying to now take that and craft the next phase, the next challenge. It may not happen this winter. We're working on how to move it to the next level and make it more effective at actually catching snakes. So we're very actively looking at it. It's going to come back, I believe, but it may be in a little different format.
As we wrap up, what are some of the challenges before your agency that will be top priority as we go into the new year?
Well, the top priority for us, one, is looking at the big picture of Florida and conservation. And developing, our commission is very engaged in developing a strategic vision for conservation in the state. And we want to bring our partners in and talk about how can we position ourselves now and do what we can to make sure we're taking care of fish and wildlife that is such a cornerstone to our economy, and want to look to the future in that regard. And the other thing is, fitting into that is working with kids and families in Florida, the youth, and making sure they understand and appreciate our fish and wildlife, the wealth and diversity that we have, and that they know about ways to connect, whether it's fishing, hunting, wildlife viewing, things like that. Those are great ways to get kids out and get them excited about the outdoors, and we believe that's a good thing for Florida.
Well, Nick Wiley, thank you so much for joining the program, and to our viewers, we'll catch you next time.